tear a petal from a rose, and the rose weeps too. Take your heart away from mine, and mine will surely break. My life is yours to make. So please keep that spark awake. Would you take the wings from birds so that they can't fly? Would you take the ocean's roar and leave just a sigh? Oh, this my heart won't let you do. This is what I beg of you. Don't take your love. Don't take your love from me. Tear a star from out the sky, and the sky feels blue. Tear a petal from a rose, and the rose weeps too. Take your heart away from mine, and mine will surely break. My life is yours to make. So please keep that spark awake. Would you take the wings from birds so that they can't fly? Would you take the ocean's roar and leave just a sigh? Oh, this my heart won't let you do. This is what I beg of you. Don't take your love. Don't take your love from me. Tear a star from out the sky, and the sky feels blue. Tear a petal from a rose, and the rose weeps too. Take your heart away from mine, and mine will surely break. My life is yours to make. So please keep that spark awake. Would you take the wings from birds so that they can't fly? Would you take the ocean's roar and leave just a sigh?
Welcome to Rick's. I hope you can all see me. I can't see you. I'm Cathy Kriger, and I'm the founder of Rick's Cafe. And I'll tell just a little story about the man that we're honoring tonight, Lennie Bluett. I first met Lennie, it was right after 9/11. I was here in Casablanca, And I decided to stay here to create Rick's Cafe. And Lennie at the time was playing at the Hyatt. And we heard this story from Lennie that his mother had been Humphrey Bogart's cook for over 30 years. And when Lennie was 21 years old in Hollywood and just starting out in the movie business, in the music business, I'm sorry, Humphrey Bogart was courteous enough to give Lennie a chance to try out for the part of Sam in the movie Casablanca. Now, Lennie was 21 years old, and they put powder in his hair, but they couldn't hide the fact that he was 6'6" tall, and Humphrey Bogart was 5'6". So, for various reasons, Lennie didn't get the part. He always said it was because he was too good looking. So Lennie didn't get a chance to play Sam in Casablanca, and I promised him right after 9/11 that when I opened Rick's Cafe, we would bring him here from Los Angeles to open the restaurant and be Sam after 60-odd years. And so we did, and we were over the years to bring him back 5 more times. And every time he came, he just was the most charming personality. He filled the room. He charmed the clients. He regaled our staff with jokes, most of which I wasn't allowed to hear, and played the piano and sang, and it just carried on as if he'd just been with us the whole time. So he was last here in 2011, and I saw him again in 2012, and he was 96 years old when he finally passed away on January 1st. And as Lennie once said to an interviewer, it was 20 years before he did pass away, he said, "If I were to die today, I would say that's fine because I've lived more than enough lives for 2 or 3 people." And that was the case. He really had quite a life. And so that's why we're all here tonight, is to celebrate Lennie and celebrate someone who lived life to the maximum. And so I hope you'll enjoy with us just a little bit of memories of Lennie and some nice jazz. Welcome.
Yeah. ships don't come very often, but I did come once or twice with the Royal Viking, and they drove us around the city, like city by day, and they pointed out Rick's Cafe at the hotel Hyatt, and I thought to myself, that's not the place where Rick's Cafe should be, because Casablanca, that was not Rick's Cafe. Anyway.
But that's where you ended up then. That's where I met you.
All time.
For the role of Sam when I was in my 20s, but I was too young to get the part of Sam. They even put gray in my hair to make me look older, but I still had this gorgeous face. I was too young.
And Lennie, you were tall.
And too tall, exactly, because Bogart was not a very tall man. But my mom was Bogart's cook for 30 years in his home, and he wanted me to have a part of Sam. In the film.
Very noble of him to have someone 1 foot taller audition for the part.
Yeah, but because, as you know, Dooley Wilson, the man that got the part, he was not very tall, but he stood up a couple of times.
But he also didn't play the piano.
And he did not play. No, yeah.
It
but
was
he
a
could
big
sing.
Scandal.
Right, but he could sing.
The mere idea of
met a client here whose cousin was the man who actually played the piano background for Dooley Wilson.
Oh, really?
So the circle has kind of come full.
Yes.
But this is the second tour that you played with us. You started right after we opened, and it was, I'll never forget the hassle of trying to set the date.
Yes.
When you when you would play, when we first started, but things have changed a lot in 3 years.
Oh, indeed, and for the better.
It's been a thrill having you back.
It's been a thrill coming home.
Yeah.
It'd be nice if I lived here.
Sure would.
Yeah.
Well, you're part of our family, and it's just been a thrill to have you here for the month.
Thank you. It's been a pleasure.
You'll always be one of us.
There a star from out the sky, and the sky feels blue. Tear a petal from a rose, and the rose weeps too. Take your heart away from mine, and mine will surely break. My life is yours to make, so that they can't fly. Would you take the ocean's roar and leave just a sigh? Oh, this my heart won't let you do. This is what I beg of you. Don't take your love. Don't take your love from me. Tear a star from out the sky, and the sky feels blue. Tear a petal from a rose, and the rose weeps too. Take your heart away from mine, and mine will surely break. My life is yours to make, so please keep that spark away. Together. Together.
You must have been a beautiful baby. You must have been a wonderful child. That was his face. It was pretty grim, because you see, in those days, they would only use you if you had real thick lips, kinky hair, and you were very, very black and shiny, and you had to act like you were an imbecile, you know, and you had to roll your eyes and as white Hollywood thought you should look. And I hate the N-word, even when blacks use it with each other. And it's worse if I hear it from some other race. People will never understand how that can upset a black person who's been through it. And at my age, believe me, I've been through it. In those days, we knew nothing about performing. No, and I always knew who I was and where I wanted, and I'd go where I wasn't wanted all the time, like buying houses in areas where they didn't want me. You know, all you have to say, I don't want you, or you can't go there, and then I'm going there. Restaurants, I'd go in restaurants, and I'd send in somebody who looked white and had them order food, and then I'd walk in about a half hour later, and the maitre d' said, oh, I'm sorry. And I said, what are you sorry about? Well, you know. We are full up, and then the girl would wait, darling, here I am, the food is on the table, come on and eat. And I would, they'd faint and I'd go on. And the waitress would walk by, and finally my white friend would pull her apron, you know, the string behind the apron, and he said, hey, we've been here for like 35.
Oh, this my heart won't let you do. This is what I beg of you.
Thank you. Good evening. We're gonna start the concert with a tune called You Don't Know What Love Is.
Thank you. Thank you. We just play a melody from Dizzy Gillespie called Night in Tunisia. We'll be right back. Thank you.
Thank you. beautiful love. Beautiful love. Choisis le tempo.
Thank you.
This melody was called Beautiful Love.
Thank you. peux baisser le micro un peu de présentation? En fait, faut pas le mettre dans les enceintes.
We just played Dorothy by Charlie Parker. I'm gonna introduce you the musician tonight. On the bass we have Hamza Souissi. Please give some applause for him. On the piano, Guillaume Desbois. On the drums, Alice Souissi. And myself, Axel. We're gonna play last tune, and then we're gonna take a break, and we're gonna let the space to this amazing saxophone player, Gilbert. So, thank you.
Yeah.
tear a star from out the sky, and the sky feels blue. Tear a petal from a rose, and the rose weeps too. Take your heart away from mine, and mine will surely break. My life is yours to make. So please, keep that spark awake. Would you take the wings from birds so that they can't fly? Would you take the ocean's roar and leave just a sigh? Oh, this my heart won't let you do. This is what I beg of you. Don't take your love. Don't take your love from me. Tear a star from out the sky, and the sky feels blue. Tear a petal from a rose, and the rose weeps too. Take your heart away from mine, and mine will surely break. My life is yours to make. So please, keep that spark awake. Would you take the wings from birds so that they can't fly? Would you take the ocean's roar and leave just a sigh? Oh, this my heart won't let you do. This is what I beg of you. Don't take your love. Don't take your love.
Thank you.
You must have been a beautiful baby. You must have been a wonderful child. That was his face. It was pretty grim, because you see, in those days, they would only use you if you had real thick lips, kinky hair, and you were very, very black and shiny. And you had to act like you were an imbecile, you know, and you had to roll your eyes and as white Hollywood thought you should look. And I hate the N-word, even when blacks use it with each other. And it's worse if I hear it from some other race. People will never understand how that can upset a black person who's been through it, and at my age, believe me, I've been through it. In those days, we knew nothing about performing arts. No, and I always knew who I was and where I wanted, and I'd go where I wasn't wanted all the time. Like buying houses in areas where they didn't want me. You know, all you have to say, I don't want you, or you can't go there, and then I'm going there. Restaurants, I'd go in restaurants. And I'd send in somebody who looked white and had them order food. And then I'd walk in about a half hour later, and the maitre d' said, "Oh, I'm sorry, And I said, what are you sorry about? Well, we are full up. And then the girl would wave, darling, here I am, the food is on the table, come on and eat. And I would, they'd faint and I'd go on. And the waitress would walk by, and finally my white friend would pull her apron, you know, the string behind the apron. And he said, hey, we've been here for like 35 minutes, aren't you going to wait on us? And she'd say, oh, I'm sorry, but you and your friends can't be served here. This was Hollywood and Vine, can you believe that? It was everywhere, man. It was everywhere, believe me. And that's when the War Department said, you've got to start using black people in films. You've got to give them good roles, and the black people are here also. Come on, you know. But no, I didn't do any marches or anything like that, and I was busy working, trying to earn money, because green is the important thing. Black has always been a thing with us, and it used to be a dirty word. You know, if I had a fight with my brother, he was about three or four shades darker than me. The worst thing I could call him, you black, you know, that would be the worst thing I'd call him. And you could go to certain, there's a certain society of light-skinned blacks that could pass for white in Washington, D.C. If you were dark, baby, you didn't get in that church, or you were more or less shunned in some of the churches there. Cause different ballgame. With gays, people are more open and very receptive to gays now, and they're even accepting them in church. My minister even mentioned something about we accept anybody who's gay, straight, or whatever, Chinese, and when we do. Like the general knowledge about Rock Hudson, we all knew, everybody, and Liberace, how could you not know? My God, how could you not know? Normally when you see a black girl with a white boy, I think the brothers kind of resent it because here's a sister, you know, an attractive sister who should be with a black guy, you know. But when they see the opposite, then they say, oh man, go, you know, like, wow, go ahead on, you know, man, get it on, you know. Now, and I think the reason about the nose is because his father continually said to him, you and that ugly big nose, you and that ugly big nose, now get in there and rehearse. I got to tell you that there was a law on the books that a black could buy a house anywhere he wanted to because he's an American citizen, but he couldn't live in it. Hello. Where she had to take off, show her tits. That, to me, well, there was no reason for her to show her tits. The white people wanted to burn them out, and my uncles and my grandfather had to sit out on the porch with shotguns. I just had to have a mink coat because my generation means you've arrived if you have a mink coat, okay? You'll never know just how much I miss you. And he said, well, you gotta have a white chauffeur and your mink coat. And drive around Sweden and let people see you so they know that you're working. Roy had his horse Trigger stuffed and in a museum up in Victorville. And I think the dog Bullet was also stuffed. And somebody said, well, when Dale dies, they're gonna stuff her. But Roy died before Dale, so she wasn't stuffed. She and when she smiled, that's all she wrote. Please excuse me. My river side. Today I call you to my river side.
again.
You must have been a beautiful baby. You must have been a wonderful child. That was his face. It was pretty grim, because you see, in those days, they would only use you if you had real thick lips, kinky hair, and you were very, very black and shiny. And you had to act like you were an imbecile, you know, and you had to roll your eyes and as white Hollywood thought you should look. And I hate the N-word, even when blacks use it with each other. And it's worse if I hear it from some other race. People will never understand how that can upset a black person who's been through it, and at my age, believe me, I've been through it. In those days, we knew nothing about performing arts. No, and I always knew who I was and where I wanted, and I'd go where I wasn't wanted all the time. Like buying houses in areas where they didn't want me. You know, all you have to say, I don't want you, or you can't go there, and I'm going there. Restaurants, I'd go in restaurants. And I'd send in somebody who looked white and had them order food. And then I'd walk in about a half hour later, and the maitre d' said, "Oh, I'm sorry." And I said, "What are you sorry about?" "Well, we are full up." And then the girl would wait, "Darling, here I am. The food is on the table. Come on, eat." And I would eat. Thank you.
Frédéric Chauvigny.
Thank you. Thank you. Okay. So I guess before we could say goodbye, I think it's time for us to play that song. The song that people usually say, play. Can you play the song? That's what we're gonna do.
This is what I beg of you. your love.